Hello and welcome to the Baptist Pulpit with Brother Ryan Goins, pastor of Way of the Cross Baptist Church in Dunlap, Tennessee. Now, if you feel the need to contact Brother Ryan, you can do so by emailing thebaptistpulpit@gmail.com. We hope you enjoy the message and that it's a help and a blessing to you.
John was a Baptist and I am a Baptist too.
Thank you for tuning in, listening to the broadcast today. Hope you're having a wonderful morning. Hope you're planning on being in God's house today. We'll start off with some singing from Mr. Dale Perry and Highland Drive. Appreciate them giving us permission to use their music on the radio. And then we'll bring a message out of Psalms chapter number 37. And I want to invite you to be with us at Way of the Cross Baptist Church, 444 Fredonia Road, Dunlap, Tennessee. Be wonderful to see you in the house of God.
In the battle for the Lord and right, keep on the firing line. If you win the victory, brother, you must fight. Keep on the firing line. There are many dangers that we all must face. If we die fighting, it is no disgrace. Cowards in the service will not find a place. So keep on the firing line.
Oh, you must fight. Be brave against all evil. Never run nor even lag behind. If you would win for God and the right, just keep on the firing line.
A soldier he can trust. Keep on the firing line. If you wear a crown, then bear the cross you must. Keep on the firing line. Life is but the labor for the master dear. Help to banish evil and to spread good cheer. Great you'll be rewarded for your service here. So keep on the firing line.
Oh, you must fight. Be brave against all evil. Never run nor even lag behind. If you would win for God and the right, just keep on the firing line.
When we get to heaven, brother, we will be glad. Keep on the firing line. How we'll praise the Savior for the call we had. Keep on the firing line. When we see the souls that we have helped to win, leading them to Jesus from the paths of sin, with a shout of welcome we will all march in. So keep on the firing line.
Oh, you must fight. Be brave against all evil. Never run nor even lag behind. If you would win for God and the right, just keep on the firing line.
Some glad morning we shall see Jesus in the air. Coming after you and me, joy's ours to share. What rejoicing there will be when the saints shall rise, headed for that jubilee yonder in the skies.
Oh, what singing,
singing.
Oh, what
oh,
shouting,
shouting,
on the happy morning when we all shall rise.
Shall rise.
Oh, what glory,
glory.
Hallelujah,
hallelujah,
when we meet our blessed Savior in the skies.
Seems that now I almost see all the sainted dead, rising for that jubilee that is just ahead. In the twinkling twinkling of an eye, change with them to be all the living saints to fly to that jubilee.
Oh, what singing, oh, what shouting, on the happy morning when we all shall rise. Oh, what glory, hallelujah, when we meet our blessed Savior in the skies.
Heavenly host, we begin to sing, singing in the Holy Ghost, how the heavens will ring. Millions there will join the song, with them we shall be, praising Christ through ages long, heaven's jubilee.
Oh, what singing, oh, what shouting, on the happy morning when we all shall rise. Oh, what glory, hallelujah, when we meet our blessed Savior in the skies.
Dear Heavenly Father, I thank you for your blessings, allowing us to be able to preach your word. Lord, I pray, dear Father, that you'll help my mouth. Lord, guide and direct my thoughts. Lord, open the ears of those that hear the word of God today. Lord, we're not just doing this because we ain't got nothing better to do. But Lord, you've laid it upon our heart to preach these messages, Lord. And I pray, dear Father, that you help me, Lord, to do all that you have done. And Lord, I pray that you'll help us to see you high and lifted up. And Lord, I pray you'll encourage that discouraged saint of God today. And we thank you for it. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. In Psalms chapter number 37 and verse number 5, the Bible says, commit thy way unto the Lord. Trust also in him, and he shall bring it to pass. Commit thy way unto the Lord, and trust also in him, and he shall bring it to pass. Those are some of the most precious words that's in this life today, is that God shall bring it to pass. No matter what we're facing, we understand God shall bring it to pass. He'll bring to pass our problems. He'll bring to pass our pains. He'll bring to pass and bring to fruition his plan, and he'll bring to pass his promises that he's made to us. First off, we notice he'll bring our problems to pass. I'm glad that I can tell you through the Word of God, he can bring my sin problem to pass. The Bible said in 1 John chapter number 8, if we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. He said if we confess our sin, verse number 9, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. I don't know about you, but I've got problem with sin. I ain't got no problem sinning. I can do that pretty well. But I've got a problem with sin. Sin troubles me, and sin bothers me, and sin separates me from my God. But I'm glad I can go to him, and he'll bring my sin problem to pass. And if I'll confess my sins, that word confess means to say the same thing God has to say about it. If I'll get on God's side against my own sin, he's faithful and just to forgive me of my sin and cleanse me from all unrighteousness. He'll bring my sin problem to pass, but not only that, he'll bring my self problem to pass. I've got problem with myself. Paul did too over in Romans chapter number 8 in verse number 21. He said, I find a law that when I would do good, evil is present with me. For I delight in the law of God after the inward man, but I see another law in my members warring against the law of my mind and bringing me into captivity to the law of sin which is in my members. O wretched man that I am, who shall deliver me from the body of this death? And then he said, I thank God through Jesus Christ our Lord. So then with my mind I myself serve the law of God, but with the flesh the law of sin. He said, I've got a self problem, and my problem is with sin, and my problem is with self. But he said, I thank God that God's going to fix it. Philippians chapter number 3, verse number 20 said, for our conversation is in heaven, from whence also we look for our Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ, who shall change our vile body, that it be fashioned like unto his glorious body, according to the working whereby he is able even to subdue all things unto himself. I've got sin problems, but I can come to him and he'll forgive me of my sin. I've got self problems, but one day he's going to fix it all, and I thank God for it. He said, no temptation is taking you except that which is common to man. But he said, with every temptation, there is a way of escape. I've got sin problem and self problems, but my God is able to help me and will bring my problems to pass. But not only do I see the problem with sin, the problem with self, but the problem with Satan, one day God's going to bring it to pass. The Bible said in 1 Peter chapter 5, verse number 8, be sober, be vigilant, for your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about seeking whom he may devour. The Bible tells me I've got an enemy in this life. I've got an enemy, and his name is Satan. But I thank God one day he's going to bring Satan to pass. He's going to get rid of him someday. The Bible said in Revelation chapter 20, verse number 10, and the devil that deceived them was cast into the lake of fire and brimstone, where the beast and the false prophet are, and shall be tormented day and night forever and ever. I'm glad I'm going to a place someday. I'm going to a new heaven and new earth someday, where no devil ever will be able to come, where no devil ever will be able to defile, because he'll be locked up in the bottomless pit, locked up in hell, cast into the lake of fire, and be tormented forever and ever. I thank God for the child of God. He's going to bring our problems to pass. He'll bring my sin problem to pass, my self problem to pass, and my Satan problem to pass. But not only will he bring my problems to pass, but he's going to bring our pains to pass. As some of you got pain in your body, some of you that are listening today are eat up with cancer, as some of you have disease all through
throughout your body. Some of you are mangled. Some of you are just fighting old age. And some of you are troubled in every aspect of your life with pain of this body. But one day God's going to fix those problems. One day if you're saved, born again, God's going to deliver us out of the body of this pain. The Bible said in Revelation chapter 21, verse number 4, "And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away." He's going to bring your body of pain to pass. He said we're going to have a body like in His glorified body. I'm thankful that God one day is going to give us a body that never knows pain, never knows sin, never knows suffering, but it'll be just like His glorified body. I'm thankful He'll bring the pains of the body to pass, but not only the pains of the body to pass, but He's going to bring the pains of the battle to pass. The Bible says in 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse number 3, "Therefore endure hardness as a good soldier of Jesus Christ." We're in a warfare. We're in a battle. If you're born again, you're in a battle against right and wrong, against God and Satan, against that which is holy and that which is unholy. And there's pains that go along with that battle. There's pain of the conflict. There's pain of combat. You got scars in your Christian life. You got wounds where you've been hurt in your walk with God. One day God's going to bring that to pass. Some of us have got pains of casualties where we've seen our brothers and sisters fall by the wayside. The Bible said that Paul cried out and said, "Demas has forsaken us, having loved this present world." I'm tired of hearing about preachers falling. I'm tired of hearing about preachers messing up and sinning against God and ruining their ministry and ruining their life and shaming the name of God. There's pain that's in this battle, this warfare that we're in. There's pain of the combat. There's pain of the casualties. But I am glad one day God's going to bring it all to pass. He said in 2 Timothy chapter 4, Paul cried out, "For I am now ready to be offered, and the time of my departure is at hand. I've fought a good fight. I've finished my course. I've kept the faith. Henceforth there's laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give unto me at that day, and not to me only, but to all them that love His appearing." I'm thankful that He's going to bring it to pass someday. He's going to bring to pass my problems. He's going to bring to pass our pain, the pain of this body and the pain of this battle that we're in. But I'm also glad He's going to bring to pass His plan. He's got a plan for you and I. He's got plans for the church. He's going to bring to pass. The Bible said in Ephesians chapter 5, verse 25, "Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ loved the church and gave Himself for it, that He might sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of water by the word, and that He might present it to Himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that it should be holy and without blemish." I'm glad He's got a plan to make us just like Him someday. He's got a plan to present me to the Father and present me to Himself holy, without blemish, without any fault, without any spot, without any wrinkle. I don't look like much now, and I fall and I falter and I mess up in my Christian life, but one day God's going to bring His plan about, and I'm going to be like Him. I see His plan for the church. Not only His plan for the church, but He's got a plan for Israel. Genesis chapter 12, verse number 2, "And I will make thee a great nation, and I will bless thee and make thy name great, and thou shalt be a blessing. And I will bless them that bless thee, and curse him that curseth thee. And in thee shall all the families of the earth be blessed." I'm thankful that we're blessed through the nation of Israel, the people of God, because our Savior came from Israel. Our Bible came from Israel. But one day there's going to be a worldwide kingdom with Jesus Christ being King and Jesus Christ being Lord. He's the King of kings and Lord of lords, and He's going to have have his throne over there in Jerusalem. And all the world's going to come and worship him there in Jerusalem. And God's going to bring his plan to pass that he has for the nation of Israel. And not only his plan for the church, his plan for the nation of Israel, but he's also got a plan for heaven and earth. The Bible said in Revelation chapter number 21, in verse number 1, he said, "And I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, Behold, the tabernacle of God is with man, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them and be their God." I'm thankful God's going to bring his plans to pass for this heaven and this earth. That Bible said in Philippians chapter number 2, He said that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow, things in heaven, things in earth, things under the earth, and every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Down here we worship gold and walk all over God, but up there one day, whenever God sends that city, New Jerusalem, down and recreates everything that's here and has a new heaven and new earth, we're going to walk on gold and we're going to worship God, and God's going to be in charge of everything. He's going to be the light of that city. I thank God one day he's going to bring his plan to pass. I'm looking for him to bring his plan to pass. But not only will he bring his plan to pass, but he'll bring his promises to pass. The Bible says in 2 Peter chapter 1, verse number 4, "Whereby are given unto us exceeding great and precious promises, that by these we might be partakers of the divine nature, having escaped the corruption that is in the world through lust." He said we've got exceeding great and precious promises. I want you to notice the promise of salvation. He said, "All that the Father giveth me shall come to me, and he that cometh to me I will in no wise cast out." He's going to bring the promise of salvation to pass. As a 7-year-old boy, Battlefield Baptist Church, Fort Oglethorpe, Georgia, I don't know if it was a Sunday or a Wednesday, I don't know what day it was, can't tell you the date, but I know one day God came by my way and he pricked my heart. He said, "Ryan Goins, I love you and I want to save you from hell." And I came down and I asked Jesus Christ to save me. I repented of my sin and believed on the Lord Jesus Christ, and he saved me that day. And I'm living in a partial victory right now, but one day I'm going to be up there in his presence. One day I'm going to have a new body. One day I'm going to be just like him. He's going to bring that promise of salvation in the past. He said in Philippians, he said, "Being confident in this very thing, that he which hath begun a good work in you will perform it until the day of redemption." I'm looking for Jesus Christ to bring my promise of salvation to pass. Now, I'm saved now as I ever will be, and I could never be saved any less. I couldn't go to hell if I wanted to, because I've been washed in the precious blood of Jesus Christ. And he said, "You hath he made to sit together and with him in heavenly places." I'm already seated in heaven with God. I'm just waiting on my body to get there with him. I look forward to God bringing to pass that promise of salvation. And if you're listening today and you've never been born again, you've never been saved, you've never been washed in the blood of Jesus Christ, that promise goes out to you. "All that the Father giveth me shall come to me, and he that cometh to me I will in no wise cast out." You say, "Well, I'm too bad." The Bible tells us about Paul. He said, "I was the chiefest of sinners. I was a blasphemer. I was a murderer. I was a liar." He persecuted the church of the living God. Yet God came to where he was, and he said, "Paul, it's hard for you to kick against the pricks." And he saved him that day on the road to Damascus. The Bible tells us about a jailer over there in Philippi. He just got done beating the preachers. He just got done chaining them up and putting them down in the dungeon. And about midnight, Paul and Silas prayed, and the jail began to shake, and all the bars were open, all the chains chains fell off, and he came down with a lion, and he said, "Sirs, what must I do to be saved?" They said, "Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved in thy house." You get in, if you're wicked and vile, you get in just like the children do. Everybody gets in the exact same way. I'm thankful for the promise of salvation. Not only the promise of salvation, but there's the promise of the second coming. Hebrews chapter number 10. He said, "For yet a little while, he that shall come will come and will not tarry." He's going to come in his appointed time. Nobody's going to stop him from coming. He said, "He that shall come and will not tarry." I see the promise of his second coming. But not only do I see the promise of his second coming, but I see the promise of Christian service. The Bible tells us in Revelation 22 verse 12, Jesus Christ was talking. He said, "Behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me, to give every man according as his work shall be." We're working, trying to do the best we know how for Christ, and sometimes we don't know if we're making any kind of difference. If we just stay steadfast. The Bible said, "Be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of God." Then he said this, and this is one of my favorite parts. He said, "For as much as you know, your labor's not in vain with the Lord." I might not ever meet any of you that's listening to this message. There's a lot of you I'll never meet in this life, but I'm looking forward to the day when God comes back with his reward, finding out what it is that God did through the preaching of his word. The Bible said in the book of Psalms 126, verse number 5, "And they that sow in tears shall reap in joy. He that goeth forth weeping, bearing precious seed, shall doubtless come again rejoicing, bringing his sheaves with him." I don't know what you're going through. I don't know what you're having to put up with. But I can guarantee you through God's word, one day he's going to bring it all to pass. One day he's going to bring all our problems to pass. I ain't going to have no problem with sin. I ain't going to have no problem with self. I ain't going to have no problem with Satan. One day he's going to bring the pains to pass. I ain't going to have no pain of the body. I ain't going to have no pain of the battle. And one day God's going to bring his plan to pass. He's going to make us like him, and doth not yet appear what we shall be. But we know that when he shall appear, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. He's going to bring the plan for the church to pass. He's going to bring the plan of Israel to pass. One day we're all going to meet over there and worship the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And he's going to bring his plan for heaven and earth to pass. It's going to be so wonderful. It's going to be wonderful being in a world where there ain't nobody cussing, ain't nobody drinking, ain't nobody fighting. Everybody just worshiping the Lord Jesus Christ. Everything just wonderful. I'm glad I'm going there someday. But then I'm glad also he's going to bring his promises to pass. He's going to bring his promises to pass. There's the promise of salvation. There's the promise of his second coming. And then there's the promise of Christian service. He said, "Therefore, my brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of God, for as much as you know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord." Dear Heavenly Father, I thank you for the opportunity to preach. Lord, I pray, dear Father, that you use the message for your will, do what you will with it. We thank you for it and give you the glory. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
You've been listening to The Baptist Pulpit with Brother Ryan Goins, pastor of Way of the Cross Baptist Church in Dunlap, Tennessee. Feel free to email thebaptistpulpit@gmail.com. Oh,